from France here. It is 10 p.m. Central Eastern Central Europe time, and it is Level Up Live, Lockdown Level Up Live number 3. Really excited to be here. I think we've got Brent in the house. Brent, are you still there? Welcome from New Zealand. Great to have you around. Yeah, love to know how you and Claire are doing. What's life like in Christchurch? Yeah, any questions, pop them out. So yeah, greetings everyone. Welcome to Lockdown Level Up Live. I am Hitt Trey. Hitt is in the house. Awesome, welcome from Mexico. Awesome to see you. Let me see there now. Can I, I am gonna... Hola, hola. Good to see you, Trey. Yeah, stick around, see if you can play with the game. Feel free to drop in and out. I've got a cup of tea here. This is really informal. I actually want to thank Trey in person. Let me elaborate on that. We have got, let's say Maureen, we got there. There's Brent from New Zealand. Maureena to you, Brent. And hola from Trey. How are you? This is awesome. Awesome. So let's just drag those down a little bit. Now I can hear. Now I just got some sound. So I'm going to come to why you just heard that sound in just a minute. And I think that is because somehow, some way, did my broadcast end? Okay, it looks okay, apologies for that. I am not too sure what happened there. I am hoping that this stream is still going. For a minute I thought it was off. Now I've got some echo going on, so I think I know what's going on. I know what's going on. So this is all part of the show, guys. This is yeah, that's what we need to do. We need to cut that out. Okay, so there's a perfect example of me stepping forward, being accountable, and things going wrong. So you should be able to hear me. I am assuming, says we're going live. Now, I'll tell you what happened. The reason I started to get a little bit concerned was I had the live YouTube page up. So this live that I'm delivering on YouTube was being fed back to me, which means I'm probably using up unnecessary bandwidth, so that was not a good idea. And so that's trying to chew through the bandwidth. So yeah, not a good idea. So I've just dropped that, and I'm hoping I can still see all of your comments as they come through. So we've got Trey Hitt in the house from Mexico. Trey is working on his adult coloring book, and my wife's business today, both feed your soul. That's awesome to hear, Trey. Now I want to thank you personally, because you were one of the inspirations behind this show. So let me, for those of you who are new here, there are some people watching, which is great to see. This is me leveling up. Let me just put some, I'm going to be here for about an hour, okay? And this is going to be really fun, and I'm just going to have a bit of fun with you guys. Yeah, so we're going to play, and if you like anything I do, you know, give me a round of applause. But yeah, I want you to join in. This show is not about me. This show is for all of us. And there was a few inspirations about how this show come together, and Trey was one of those inspirations. Also, Trey, can you correct me if I'm pronouncing your name correctly or not? So what are some of these inspirations, and why have we got Lockdown Level Up? Well, obviously, you know, these are very unusual times, a lot of people are confined. But I was listening to a podcast from a friend of mine, and during this podcast he said that, you know, now is not the time that people can use the excuse of time, of not having time to follow through on their ideas and business development and marketing. You know, this is a time for a lot of people, not for everyone. Obviously, there's a lot of people who are busy on the opposite end. Excuse me, just there's a little bit distraction. Brent, thanks for sharing that. He's still here. Awesome to hear. Let's see, I'm still here. Yep. I have, that might have been to do with me, Brent. I might have been pushing the boundary a little bit on that with the upstream and the downstream. So, and I'll get to why that sort of experiment is going on. So, great to have you here. So, my podcast friend was saying, you know, this is not the time to, let pass in terms of working on yourself. And, you know, he used the word impoverish, and I'm not 100% sure that that's really the deal. How does that get over there? Okay, Trey, thanks very much. That's good to know. Okay, I think I might have had something to do with that intermittency, so I hope you guys will bear with me. Why are we here? And I'm just playing around with the sound as well. Let me know if I'm too. I'll get to why I'm going off on these tangents as well as part of this. But I'm playing around with new software, which is a significant reason why I'm here. So I'm just playing around with sound. Everything is new. Everything is an experiment. But let's get back. Podcast. He said, if you get out of this confinement period and you haven't leveled up, you haven't learned something new. I don't think he even used leveled up, though. I came up with that. He said, you know, if you haven't developed yourself, worked on your mindset, worked on your business, worked on yourself, you don't come to the end of this period without some new skills and some new knowledge. You only have yourself to blame when things get back to normal and others have moved on, you know. So now's not the time to, now's not the time to over binge on Netflix. Now's not the time to over binge on your gaming or some of your bad habits. You know, now's the time to actually get stuck into some of those things that really matter. And I know Trey, I hope you don't mind me mentioning, I'm going to put you on the spot a little bit. I'm going to come back to you, but I know Trey's working on this adult coloring book, and I'm really keen to learn more about that. And maybe Trey can come on the show a bit later or another day and show us how he's getting on with that. Brent, I always know you are working on something, my friend, so you come on too. Any new books? What about some illustrations from Christchurch? We would love to see them. Big shout out to Brent. Brent was the is a good friend of ours back in Christchurch, New Zealand. But Brent was the illustrator for Ellie's book, Burning Fat for Good. I should put a link up onto that sometime. But yeah, the Holistic Guide to Burning Fat for Good is available on Amazon, written by Ellie, and Brent was the illustrator. So yeah, come share an illustration, Brent. I'll get to, okay, loads of challenges. I want this to be fun. Woohoo! Let's have a bit of sound. Right, so my friend said impoverished, so there was some else that needed to be done. And so then the next thing that happened is, and this is where Trey comes in. So Trey was introduced to me online through a world schooling network, and he and I got together. We had a chat online over Zoom, one-to-one, and he was trying to breathe life into an accountability group around our world schooling community that we both belong to. And he told me some of the things he's working on, things he was trying to do, and it just got my juices flowing a little bit, reflecting on you know, what Trey was trying to achieve with his accountability. How could I contribute to the We Are World Schoolers group, run by a very good friend, Lainey Liberty? I'll talk more about that another time, a bit later perhaps. I said to Trey I was a little bit out of sync on the time zone, but there were some things I would sleep on. I let him know that I had been an accountability coach in the past and run groups professionally. and I felt I could add some value. He had some ideas, and we both sort of agreed that we would sleep on things and get back in touch. So I'm being challenged by one friend around, you know, learn something new, master something new. Then talked to Trey. He's talked about some needs that are going on in the We Are World Schooler, World Schooler community. oh, I love it, love it. Talk to Trey, and we promised we will sleep on it and we will share ideas. So then, of course, I started watching some mentors of myself, some mentors of my own in the online marketing world and the online space, and I saw how they were making themselves available in a sort of ask me anything style. And I thought, well, yeah, actually, I probably do have more to share than I maybe give myself credit for. You know, Ellie and I have been location independent, world schooling, traveling family for 3 years now. We are currently coming at you from France, and this is, we literally got here about a week before the world went crazy after spending 3 years in Southeast Asia. So it's been a massive change for us, and I'll be more than happy to talk about the world schooling side of things a bit later. And go from there. So we know that, you know, there's people needing community connection. It isn't easy to get out, obviously. I mean, I'm used to going to co-working spaces, and you know, that's not available. A lot of us are locked up, different rules in different countries. You know, Brent, maybe you can tell us what's going on in New Zealand. Trey, what's the lockdown rules in Mexico? Let people know. Actually, just while I remember, if you're watching the show, where in the world are you? Tell me in the comments. Let's find out where everyone is coming in from. Okay. I don't know what happened there. Let's get back to the default scene. Yeah, trust you're hearing me loud and clear with those comments. So yeah, where in the world are you? And let me know. So yeah, there was a need for some compassion and some connectivity, and yeah, so here I am. I am making myself available. If anyone wants to talk about any online challenges around content optimization, search engine optimization, keyword research, Ellie and I have got a few runs on the board with email automation, running sequences, email pop-ups, and I talked about the convert box and software we use and the convert kit software we use, two different companies. There are links to those in the description. But you know, I'm more than happy to use this show as an opportunity. I can screen share. So, you know, if any of you have something you want to, if any of you, you know, you want to see something, I can shoot, we could do a tutorial, or I could show you behind the scenes, you know, in detail something, and we can, yeah, let me know, you know, if, so what do we got? Let me just show you here. If we go up here, if you go to this website, you'll see a lot of the digital nomad tools we use. If you go to that website and see anything that you use or have been planning to use or don't know how to use, we would be more than happy to dive in and see if we can sort of get you started on that road. We will be updating that page. I'm not actually sure it shows very well on an iPad, so if you are using an iPad and you go to that page and it all looks messy, please let me know, because I need to fix that. The website's had a major overhaul. Again, love some comments on what you think of the website. We have three websites. They've all had a major overhaul, so we've got some experience building websites. Let us know what you think of the websites, and if you'd like something similar, maybe we can help you with that. Yeah, website reviews. If you want a website review, just type your website in the comments and we'll put on the clock. See up here, got a little clock, and we can have a countdown timer and we'll do a little review of your website, give you some feedback, and you can take away some take homes and go and see if you can improve your website. So say lots of tangents here, lots of tangents. And so when this challenge around stepping up and learning something new, I've been meaning to just do live video and more video for a long while. I've been talking about it. I've kind of been sporadically dropped into video. If you follow our YouTube channel, we've got a very small following, but a few videos up there, but it's all been very ad hoc. Did get a 10-week playlist up there recently, but you know, we run out of juice to, we have heaps of content. It's just the time and effort it takes to editing and all those sorts of things is just very, it just takes a lot out of us. And we're working on the okay, I'll get to that a bit later. I've got at least an hour's washing up to do. It is 10 p.m. here. There's not enough hours in the day, and the washing up, feeding our family just stacks up, and there's no dishwasher here, so I am the dishwasher, and I'm going to have to do it before we go to bed. So it's going to be a late night for me, 10:30 already, but loving being here, talking to you guys. And you know, please welcome anyone on. So I keep going off lots of tangents, but this is all part of the show. Want some fun. We we wanted to have, we've been wanting to do more in the video space and wanted to do more live video. And you know, say this isn't the first time, but I've never really got it habitual. But I have been using, or I've been subscribing to some software called Ecamm Live, and this is how I'm broadcasting to you now. So everything, all the sort of little sound effects and the videos coming on and off, the screen sharing, all this is down to a software called Ecamm Live. And if you're interested, I can sort of show you behind the scenes with that. There's a mode where I can actually sort of share my desktop and you see Ecamm Live, and you can kind of see my dashboard so that I can see the comments. So like, I think you've already noticed, if you've just come on, you know, I can add a comment that, you know, that's coming straight from Trey as a YouTube comment. That'll come off the screen in 15 seconds. This little thing over here, this is a little transparency that I can, you know, run manually. And now I wanted to show you, I want that back up. Okay, what am I missing? I am missing, got the comments coming in. Trey says, let's see what Trey says here. Lockdown in central Mexico, still businesses and restaurants closed down, local markets still open at least. Well, that's good, you know, because here we don't really even have that. But having said that, the supermarkets are open, so that would be, yeah, that would be the same. I went off on a tangent. So I wanted to upskill in this software. I've been subscribing to it, not been really using it. So I was like, no, now is the time. And so I took this sort of challenge from my friend Martin. I took my conversation with Trey. I saw what my other online mentors were doing, and I took my own, like, well, we've got the software, we've got the time and availability, we've got to juggle it, we have two small children, now is the time. So this is it. I just kind of created it over the weekend and decided I'm just going to jump in. And so I'm putting myself out there now, making myself vulnerable, and I'm showing you that what you're seeing is not perfection, okay? It is not perfection. This is just about leveling up, trying something new, and seeing where it takes us. I know I can do better with the online video, and I've got this toolkit, and I need to use it. I need to practice. So let me tell you how you can help, because I want this to be fun. So Ecamm Live has 6 sound effects. Okay, and I'm just going to quickly run them. You've heard a couple of them. Here's the applause. Hey, go. Okay, we got the bicycle horn. We got the DJ air horn. Check that out. We got the glockenspiel. We got the party noise maker. Everyone loves a popper, eh? And then we got the triangle. So, I have a challenge. I want you to help me out. I want you to help me build my sound effects. Now, let me see if I have lost my overlays. I want my show overlays. What is missing? Hide all scene overlays. Okay, let's just turn the comments off for a second. So I'm going to turn my comments off. Ah, here we go. That's what I want, overlays. And what I need to give you, I need to give you a couple of things. I need to give you that, take away that. Okay, and, but sorry, I'm going off on a tangent. Okay, what I want to know is send your sound. Don't just sit there playing your guitar. Step forward and tell us that you're gonna show us how you're progressing, and maybe you can come on tomorrow or the day after, and then you can come back a week later. You know, challenge yourself to learn a new chord or learn a new tune or whatever. I said Brent is an illustrator, so Brent is working on celebrant systems, completing. Let's just bring that in, my friend. That is, let's bring those comments up. This is awesome. Brent is working on celebrant systems, completing a Prince 2 project management qual, developing youth. Brent, awesome stuff. Let's, you know, come and tell us more about that, my friend. Come and tell us more about that, friend. So that leads me over down in the bottom screen. You'll see my Skype ID. Okay, how this works is Ecamm Live works beautifully in tandem with Skype. So I haven't actually got Skype open at the moment, but I'm going to get into the habit of get in the habit of firing Skype up. And all you need to do is connect with me on Skype. We probably should do that before the show. It could get a bit time consuming trying to make that work out before, but add me, you know, Skiwi Cole, that is my Skype connection. But what happens is when Skype fires up, Ecamm Live sees the call and we will be able to chat side by side on the screen, and you can play your ukulele, show us your coffee book tray, you know, or anything you're working on. You know, what are your kids doing? On day one, my eldest 6-year-old, she came up and showed us what she had been drawing and what she was leveling up on, which was her drawing and artwork. So plenty to do. Now, Trey, Brent, looking to ebook my Rekindle Your Book. Okay, tell us more about that, my friend. Tell us more about that. Only essential workers, we can go to Superman exercise with distance. Okay, so awesome, thanks for letting us know. So okay, righty-ho. So we got these guys working on some things. I'm here on this. I want your sound effect. Okay, let's go. Don't forget, if you're just joining, where in the world are you? Tell us what's going on with lockdown where you are. We know in central Mexico it's lockdown, and businesses still open, restaurants closed down, local markets still open. So yeah, where in the world are you? Back in Christchurch. Just trying to find the comment. Stream has improved. Brent, Murray, Brent, we are in day 22, 28 national lockdown, all going well. Good to hear from our fellow New Zealanders. Okay, if you're new, if you just come on the show, where in the world are you? Let's find out. I'm just put it out there. Brent, are you in a position? Would you like to come on the show and tell us anything you are working on? Show us an illustration, play a tune on the ukulele, putting you on the spot. Trey, likewise, putting you on the spot. Would you like to come on the show? Show us some drafts of your coffee book. Let me see that you are making progress. Let's step forward and get out of our comfort zones. Let's show other people that we can do this. Let's start the party. If you need to, I will fire up Skype with much enthusiasm and we can make it happen. Go away, something's come up on my screen. Don't want you, that's a notification thing. What happened there? I've just gone on to a different screen. There we go, awesome. I am going to fire up Skype because we can and we are here to have fun. All right, so I don't know what happened then. Are you you should still just be able to see me. You should still be able to see me. So I've got Skype open, and I'm just gonna see if the guys check in. I'm just gonna move that over there, because if I move that over there, oh, I love that. I'll know if you are coming to the party. So there is a lot you can do with Ecamm Live. So I can plug in different microphones, I can plug in different cameras. So I don't know if you can see just behind me, so I'm sitting in the kitchen. We are house sitting, by the way. If you are new to the show, you don't know anything about us, we are a location independent family. We're originally from New Zealand, but we no longer have a home. We have been 3 years permanently traveling, mainly in Southeast Asia, for virtually, you've got a 3 year anniversary in awesome, thank that's this way. Trey's getting on the case, da 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 da, cool, awesome, lovely. Awesome, mate, let's make it happen. I'm going to play around with the time zones, Brent, so I'll make sure that we do more at this time if I know you guys are going to be there. I'm going to do some early ones, which will probably work for Trey and those in the American areas, but we're just going to play around with this. So there's lots you can do with this software. So I went off on a tangent. What do we do? Okay, see those two green things over there? They are actually that's a Canon EOS M6 digital mirrorless camera. And that was part of my investment in leveling up quite a while ago. And one of those investments that you kind of knew you were going to get around to using, and we've done a little bit with it, but I haven't really mastered the tool. Not doing as much, and it's so easy to do good photos on your phone. Ellie and I both have, we didn't for a while, but we now have pretty decent phones to take really good photos. But I have tested, and the camera that I just showed you behind me does plug into my MacBook Pro. So just to let you know, for those of you who are into the technology, so I'm broadcasting to you using some software called Ecamm Live. It only works on Mac. There are similar tools, I don't believe as good, but there are similar tools that do work on Windows, but this particular tool is purely a Mac, and so I'm using a MacBook Pro. Now, I'm using quite an old MacBook Pro. I look after my stuff. But it seems to be working, you know, it goes well. And you can plug a camera in. So it is possible that I can sort of have a camera over here or up above. So the camera that's coming at you now is the inbuilt camera in the MacBook Pro. So which is why you've got quite a grainy look, and it's not probably great quality video. I'm using a headset. I don't have a great microphone setup. I wouldn't want to rely on the inbuilt microphone. I think it would work, but you know, these things, it's more important that you can hear me. And you know, note to self, keep your hands away from your mouth, because that doesn't help. So I've been, you know, also dabbling with the idea of a podcast. So I say the idea is sold to me. The idea was sold to me over 3 years ago, but the technique, you know, preparing for that journey has been a challenge, and I'm not ready for it. But this is part of going live, creating audio and video content, putting it in a place where I can get it and use it elsewhere. Will help me practice on the podcast. So this is all me, guys, leveling up, letting you know how I want to get better in the online space, creating visual and audio content, and these lives are my way of doing that. So you know, give me your feedback, and let me give you feedback on what you're working on, you know, and we can have some accountability, we can have some masterminding, and we can have some fun while we're doing it, until we're all allowed out and sit in restaurants and drink coffee and drink beers. Not that I drink anymore. Okay, right. So I would like to play around with the technology, which is why I asked you to send me a sound effect. You know, go off and find me a sound effect, or even a GIF. you know, maybe I can do a little visual and we can create some themes around the sound effects. Or what else did here's a question for you guys. Let's get my scenes up. And I want to know, guys, what are you reading right now? Okay, because I am reading, I'm reading this. What's he doing? There we go. In Praise of Slow by Carl Honore. I don't know how you say that. Carl Honore. Whoa, what are you doing? Can you read that? I'm loving this book. I have to confess, I'm reading it quite slowly. That's just coincidental, but it's mainly because there's not enough hours in the day, you know. And like I say, I mean, it's going to be 11:30 by the time this show finishes, and then I've probably got an hour's washing up to do. So, and then I might just want to relax and wind and just calm down a little bit. And so I'm not getting to my book every night. My two children keep me on my toes. I actually went out to the supermarket today. So yeah, we're in lockdown here. I went off at a tangent earlier. We are house sitting in rural France. We're about, actually, I don't know exactly how south of Paris we are. We kind of say we're central France. It took us, when we flew in to Charles de Gaulle, it took us an hour and a half on a fast train and then another sort of 45 minutes car ride. So I guess we're a fairly significant distance, but it's just it was all on a train and it all happened what seemed relatively quickly. So maybe we're a lot further south than we realize, but we're in a very rural area. So we are in a hamlet of 5 houses, which means no shops. It's just like we're in the middle of fields and woods. I actually driving across the road today, two baby deer shot across the road in front of me. It's not hunting season, there's no human beings out, and we are seeing wildlife in the woods. It was beautiful. Ellie and the girls have been out in the woods and they've seen some larger deer inside the woods, but I haven't been with them when they've seen the deer. And then so it was a real nice surprise to see these like little, I call them reindeer because they were quite small. Ellie says the ones she's seen are much bigger, and they were bounding. The ones I saw were bounding across the road, whereas the ones she's seen have been around the woods that are behind our house. So we are house sitting for an Australian family. Sorry, we're house sitting for a British family living in France who have gone to Australia to look after their son who is not well, and we're in the middle of nowhere. You know, our neighbors are wind farms. That's sort of how remote it is. And sorry, off on tangent. So Trey, I will come back to you with Skype in just a minute. We're house sitting in rural France with no neighbours. Oh, sorry, 4 neighbours, all speaking French. There's 4 houses, and I don't think they're all occupied. And then we're about 4.5 kilometres from the nearest village. In the nearest village, there is a bakery, a hairdresser's, a library that opens 1 or 2 days, and that's it. Very little else. I think there's a park and a mini golf course. It's weird, you know. I mean, there was hardly anyone here in the first few days before lockdown came, and then we're 17 k's from the nearest sort of small town, bigger village, and that's where I go for the supermarket. That's why I brought this story up. Okay, so this town is much bigger. It's got 4 supermarkets. Both in the kitchen, my friend. Both in the kitchen. I'm going to eat the chocolate biscuits next time. I started yesterday's show eating a chocolate biscuit. Went live and I was still eating my chocolate biscuit, you know, but this is what it's all about. Yeah, come and have some fun. So this was a tangent of my day. So the girls haven't been out for weeks, but we're quite fortunate. The house is the biggest we've lived in. So there's no sort of we're very blessed. You know, if we'd been in Asia when this had happened, we might have got quite claustrophobic. We loved our time in Southeast Asia, but that was because we were out and about, working, integrating with society. We ate out a lot in Southeast Asia because it was cheaper to eat out than it was to cook, and we didn't have the washing up, that's for sure. So that was pretty cool. But if we had been stuck, our final destination was the Philippines, and we loved it there, but I'm not too sure that the accommodation that we're in an Airbnb, Ayla was having an awesome time. She made more friends in that Filipino area than anywhere else, and it was amazing. But it was like, you know, there was lots of ants in the kitchen. The kitchen was just like, you know, just a bench, and if we wouldn't have been able to get fresh food. They're not high, the Philippines doesn't have a lot of vegetables, and Ellie's a vegetarian. It would have been a struggle. We're positive, optimistic people. It would have been a struggle. We feel that serendipity and lady luck shined on us, bringing us to France and landing us in this wonderful house here. We got a big house, we got space. We just stare out at countryside. We have 2 acres of gardens. Yes, I need a ride on mower. That's how we pay the rent here, do the lawns, although I've broken the mower and I've got to fix it. Waiting for a part to come, so that was interesting. But our hosts have been amazing, and we have a great relationship with them over Messenger. You know, they love the fact that we're here enjoying their garden and their land. And you know, I've set up a climbing frame for Ayla, and we've cleared out an outdoor bath, and the girls are having water play, and the dog can run around. And you know, you go in the woods and see reindeer. It's like, wow, we can go out and get fresh air, which a lot of people can't. So there was a very, very, very long-winded way of telling you I went shopping today. But supermarket shopping for me is turning into a sort of once every 10 days hit, and it is taking over half a day. I am loading up a trolley like I have never loaded up before. Ellie likes her food and we're determined not to go hungry. And the trolley, it is stressful trying to find everything in a foreign language, and find everything in a foreign language, and then trying to keep the trolley from not squashing everything. And then I get to the checkout and I have to take it all out, and what's in the trolley takes up 3 checkouts, if that makes sense. So like, the lady's scanning my stuff, I haven't emptied the trolley, I'm like a third of the way through the trolley, and there's not enough room for her to scan anymore. So I have to go around the front, load up a few bags to give her room to get a bit more through. Then I have to go back to the trolley, get some more out while she scans, then try and go around. I don't have enough bags for the trolley. And then people, you know, there's not a lot of people in supermarkets, but there's enough. And it is, you know, you can't help but be stressed. And I'm like, you know, I don't want to be doing this. And I had to do 2 runs to the car to, because I had to get let other customers through. I had to move my supermarket shopping onto the empty checkout next door just so that she could serve the next customer. But then there wasn't enough room to get that into the trolley now that it's in a few bags. So I had to take the trolley out to the car and then load the boot up, load the seats up, come back, grab what was left. You know, someone could have stole my stuff, I'm sure, but you know, no one's going to do that. But then go and then come back and grab the rest and take it from there. So yeah, cool. Right, let's see what's going on in the comments here. We have got Trey, you've gone. I'm going to come back to you and we're going to talk. Brent, you're trying to get I'm going to find Trey, but Brent's going to sort his out. What's Brent? Brent, what are you reading, Brent? Brent's reading. Oh wow, is that the guy who died? No, obviously not. No. Wasn't the guy who tried that and he died? He didn't make it, and he had a young family. Interesting. Trey is reading the continuum concept, all about indigenous knowledge right now. Cool. Yeah, you were telling me about that in Mexico. That's interesting. That's really interesting. The second book is slowing down. So yeah, I think you're talking about. Trey, is that the second book that you're reading, or is that a follow-up to Carl Hanare's How to Create? I want that to go away. Go away. Oh no, sorry, Brent. Brent is slowing the book. Second book. Brent, sorry, I pug you. Is that? How to Create. Oh, okay. Yeah, sorry. I got that. Yeah, that's awesome. So, yeah, and Ellie's diving. You know, there's another thing. Serendipity. This house. You know, the British retired British couple whose house this is have a lovely library of personal development stuff. And there's, you know, there is quotes up on the wall. The book is full of the house is full of bookshelves, and the books are full of inspiration. And anyone who knows us, when we did have a house and were stationary, we worked on ourselves a lot. We did a lot of personal development. And anyone who does that, big shout out to you guys. To have access to these books and our eldest, who has pretty much taught herself to read, you know, she is 6 years old and she can read amazingly well. So, okay, guys, we've been going for about 45 minutes. I want to bring some people on the show. Trey has put himself forward, and we're going to wrap up in about 15 to 20 minutes. Remember, if you come on, tell us where in the world are you. Leave your destination or your location in the comments. Actually, be very interested to hear what is the lockdown state. And I posted a question on Facebook today about, it's mainly to world schoolers, and you know, are you up against visa extensions? Which country are you in, and what are you up against? I got some really interesting responses. Maybe I will look at those tomorrow. So Trey, so how people, let's just find, search for people. Trey Hitt. Trey, is it Tarpon Springs, United States? Would that be right? I'm saying hi. Waiting for you to accept my invitation. Are we good? Says you're snoozing. I've obviously got the delay, so there will be a delay. So although I'm doing this right now, Trey will be hearing this 15 to 30 seconds later, I guess. And so Trey, when you get it, if this is you, and I hope it's you, just ring, and that should fire Skype up. And if it doesn't, that's all part of the learning curve. So let's go back to the show, and here we go. So I'm gonna try how does this work? Might be another profile. Okay. All right. Okay. Oh yeah. No, that's you, man. That's you. Yeah. Looks like an orange. That is you. Yeah. Looks like an orange. I think so. I think that's you. I haven't got a. Yeah, I'm waiting. It says I'm waiting for you to accept the invitation. So, hopefully, you can see that. It says you're in Tarpon Springs, Florida. Which I know you're not, but I'm guessing that's where you registered for Skype or yeah, don't sweat the small stuff. Yes, so we're not going to sweat the small stuff. Great book. I haven't read that, but I've heard lots of good things about it, and we're not going to sweat the small stuff. Hopefully Trey's going to get on the he's going to see my invitation. Definitely looks like an orange or a tennis ball. Trapex. So yeah, I'm pretty sure that's you, Trey. I'm pretty sure that's you, my friend. So might be another profile. Looks like an orange. Okay, let's share the screen. And so Trey, I'm sharing the screen. Is this you, my friend? Is that you? Is that you? Okay, just should show up that I've sent you an invite, or we've got this kind of message going on. So okay, yeah, if you didn't get a ding, maybe just go manually into live. Let's go back to the cool. All right. So what should happen now is Trey should, when he gets that, he's gonna ring, and I should be able to bring him on. I should be able to bring him on the show. But this is part of the experimentation. I've only ever done this once before with the Skype, and it was a long while ago. And the software's been updated a little bit. I don't quite know exactly how it works, but I know it did work. That tells, I just got a ding. Great, now we can cool. Right, Trey, just ring me and let's talk. Tell me what you're up to, what you're working on, and really keen to learn more about this coffee book. I know And what should happen? It should. Here we go. We are gonna go. Look at this. There he. How are you, my friend? Now, what I need to do is I need to see if I can split screen. I don't know how. Brent, what does this look like to you? But what I think we've got here is we've got Trey on the main screen. Would that be right? And I am in picture in picture. So there is a way to get us side by side, but I don't know how to do it. So I'll do that another day. Okay. So a big round of applause for Trey and a round of applause. Yeah. So. I believe that you can do. I've seen some others. They plug. Ecamm Live doesn't directly work with Zoom, but apparently you can plug an iPad into your USB port, so you could have your Zoom going on your iPad, and Ecamm Live would see the iPad, and so you could share the iPad screen. So this is something that I'm going to experiment with. And as part of my, you know, stepping up. So there's different ways we can do this, but I'm absolutely stoked. So Trey, enough of me. I've been doing all the talking. Tell us about the coffee. You briefly mentioned it the first time we met. So this is only the second time you and I have spoken. Tell us about the coffee book and the background and what you're trying to achieve with it. And if you've got anything you want to show us, you know, put it up on the screen.
Hey, sure thing. So actually this started because I break bones, like it's my job. I have osteoporosis and I've probably got about a dozen active fractures in my spine, so I need to keep exercising. I need to walk. And with the walking, I take with me my grown-up camera. And since I have an affiliation for, what they call them, classic VW Beetles, and I'm in a part of the world where there's still a ton of classic VW Beetles, I started taking pictures of the Type 1 sedans, just side on, and I ended up with about 600 different individual Beetles.
Wow.
Yeah. It's a lot.
Yeah.
It's a lot, and it's still there's still hundreds more, I'm sure. But at some point you have to move on from that addiction. And so I started putting together a coffee table book, just because of the relationship between the car and the area here. It's much more than just a way to get from point A to point B. It's tied into the DNA of the anarchist society here in Oaxaca, Mexico.
Wow.
So I've created a coffee table book, if you would. It's 200 pages. It's my first shot at something like this. And it's all ready to roll. It's in. I've got 202 PDFs ready to upload into a book printer. I originally had a book printer found in Texas with a decent quote, and then a friend pushed me toward China because it's a much cheaper quote. And then I had a local friend call me out on creating a book that's everything Mexico, and it should be printed here in Mexico. And as soon as I capitulated there and thanked her for that, the wheels fell off the
board. All right.
So that's where that book is right now.
So
in the meantime, go ahead.
I was just going to say, what is the next step with the book then, in light of the circumstances? Is there a holding pattern, or is there like a plan B that would allow you to move it on, or could you take an alternative route and then come back to the original route?
Well, I think we're just in a holding pattern. The original plan, if you would, was to create this book, sell it, and have the proceeds purchase a classic VW Beetle or a microbus, and we short-circuited that part, and we went ahead and bought a classic VW Beetle that I'm still waiting on the final adoption papers. We had to register it in our name.
Right.
So in the meantime, I'm creating a coloring book, which is using actually a lot of the same imagery that's in the coffee table book. It's just I run it through Photoshop because I'm a nerd and create pages that are black and white lined. So it's a coloring book, and shrunk that down to 50 pages or 25 of the images, and have creating a story arc, because I'm mostly kid, I had to name the car, and so we're here in Mexico, and VWs down here are called Bochos or Bochitos,
right.
Small Bochos, and so we named this car Frida Bochita.
Have you got any pictures? So, can you share a picture or anything?
If I can share a screen here,
I think you should be able to in Skype. And I don't know what would happen, but let's give it a whirl.
Yeah, I'm looking. I see chat. I see open a conversation. Oh, share a screen. Yeah, let's do this. Let me know if Let me know if I'm sharing the screen.
It's coming. And Brent says that's awesome, which I assume is he's talking about your coffee book. we can see your screen now, and hopefully maybe Brent can give us some. Oh, look at that! Oh, that's
so.
Wow.
Yeah, this is what the rendering looks like, and the book is titled Frida Bochita Meets New Friends.
Oh.
And so let me see if I can actually find a picture of Frida. There she is.
Wow.
Frida's a 2001 classic VW sedan one. Now in Mexico, they made this style, this classic VW style, up until 2004. And so she's all VW bug. It's just that she's only 19 years old instead of 50.
She looks beautiful. She looks beautiful.
Oh, she is. And she's going to look great with a unibrow across the front there.
Now, forgive me, what is a unibrow?
Well, yeah, Frida Kahlo, the artist. Let's see. She's the iconic, of course, the iconic Mexican painter.
Okay.
And it's mostly famous for her unibrow.
Ah.
And so since we're doing this, the concept is eventually to paint a unibrow across the hood, and then
okay,
and just paint the car flowers and a couple of monkeys and a cat, just because.
Just because. All right. Okay. Well, this is awesome, Brent. I hope you're watching, and you're up next when you get to Skype. And if anyone else is watching, this is so Trey, I'm just going to put you on the informal spot here, around the accountability.
Perfect.
Around the accountability, but you can resist it, push back or whatever, and if you don't want to play with it, it's entirely up to you. I'm just going with what you told me last week. Is there anything that I can do for you to hold you accountable to moving forward with any of your projects? And do you want to come back in X amount of days or weeks and share your progress?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm as you mentioned before, we are still in the midst of creating a small business mastermind accountability group with the We Are World Schoolers Facebook community, and I've got a couple of friends that we've had an accountability get shit done group going for a couple of years, and so with the combination of that, I've got a pretty tight timeline on pushing this book out, the coloring book out to publish, and I'm a week and a half out from that. It's not this coming Monday, but the following Monday.
All right.
Is the date that it will be available on Amazon or Kindle Direct, and as an ebook.
Okay.
So I will gladly check in at any time. But
what?
And this is good for me. This is good for me to have a tight timeline, because another thing about me is I've got full blown ADHD, and As my wife would tell you, that it's the enjoyable ADHD.
Right, I get it.
Because again, it makes me very toddler-like.
Okay.
In a lot of ways.
That's awesome.
And so to have this kind of tight timeline feeds into it.
Brendan
keeps the excitement.
Yeah, Brent didn't say that's awesome for that, but I'm going to borrow his quote and say that's awesome because of that. You know.
No, it's a beautiful thing, my friend, and I love what you're doing here. I love the technology connection.
That's awesome.
I wish I had a Mac so I could use Ecamm, but I'm slumming it with a with an HP laptop here.
Yeah, I will try to find out what the Windows equivalent is, but I know I'm in a mastermind group with some, you know, video people, and so that I know there are Windows equivalents, and I'll try and find out what they are. Okay, well, why don't we, in the interest of keeping it all sharp and everything, I'm really stoked that you took, you know, you stepped up and joined me, and we both had this chance to continue the connection, and hopefully we can share this with other people. And going back to the We Are World Schoolers, I mean, what you and I are doing right here, right now, this minute, hopefully is giving you and I both maybe some ideas, some more ideas to sleep on, you know, how could we bring this into We Are World Schoolers? Could we bring it into World Schoolers exactly as it is?
Could be, man. This is food for the heart right here, man.
Yeah. And, you know, I'm more than happy to play around with the Zoom idea, because with Zoom we could have more people come into the group. So if I can get, you know, maybe that's what we could do. Maybe, you know, you now know that what I'm doing, you can look out for new lives. I'm going to experiment with different times, but I know the time zone you're in. I'll plug an iPad in and see if I can make it work. And if we can get a Zoom going on and have more than one person in on the call, I don't know how many I can have on Ecamm Live. I'll talk to the Ecamm Live guys and see if they can do more than... Actually, I think I can have up to five. So I wonder if it can piggyback off of Skype. And that might work. Anyway, so this is me and you to-ing and fro-ing with some ideas that we could experiment with outside We Are World Schoolers. And when we know it works, then we can just go and maybe, instead of me going live on our own channel, we could try it inside We Are World Schoolers. Because although I'm broadcasting direct to YouTube, I can broadcast direct to Facebook. But on my level, I don't know whether I can broadcast live to a group or whether I would have permission. But anyway, I'm off at a tangent. You and I can share this with Lainey, and we can see where it takes us. So plenty of food from thought. So okay, well, you have an open invite, my friend. You come back on the show anytime and you show us that coloring book. You know, either before it goes up on Amazon, or when it isn't on Amazon, then give us the link. And so, you know, by then maybe we've got some more people watching and they can go to Amazon and see your coloring book and purchase it. And wouldn't that be great, you know? And then, you know, my mission, your mission would all be starting to take on some shape. So that's fantastic. So cool. All right. What I suggest you do is you just end the Skype call, and then I probably should take over the screen, and I'll talk to you soon. Wow, that, check that out. So we just had Trey Hitt on the show, folks, and Trey was stepping up, leveling up, by letting us know that he is working on a coloring book, and that he's also set a deadline for himself to get it up on Amazon. So, you know, what are you working on? What do you want to make happen? Let's have some fun. Let's give Trey a big round of applause. Isn't that cool what he's doing? Brent in the chat, if you go back in the chat, what Brent is, what's Brent working on? I'm just scrolling back through the chat here. Brent, because Brent's working on some amazing stuff. Brent is working on Celebrant Systems. If you're not from New Zealand, Celebrant is, I'll let Brent tell you another time, but a celebrant is someone who can conduct funerals and weddings. And I know that Brent did not used to do that, and he upskilled, he leveled up, and I know that he will follow through with the other things that he's doing. So he's going to come on the show. He's promised to get on the show and tell us more about some of the other things that he is working on. So yeah, we've been going just over an hour, and it's been awesome to have some new friends and old friends come on the show. I invite anyone who is watching, whether you're watching live or whether you're on the recording, this show is for you to come on the show, have some fun. You know, if you're working on something professional, come and share it with us. But if you're just doing something to, you know, grow, you know, like I said, I use the example of musical instrument. If now's the time that you're learning a new musical instrument, or your kids are learning a musical instrument, you know, come on the show, play a tune, let us know how you're getting on. It's, you know, it's a small group, it's an intimate group, and let's encourage us to do things. If you've been watching, you'll see that Trey came on using Skype through my Ecamm Live software, and my leveling up is around using Ecamm Live. And what can we do with it? I set a challenge earlier, and let's see if we can bring back the. I want to. Yeah, send me a sound effect. I've only got 6 sound effects, so I want some more sound effects so we can play with this, and maybe we could have some themes for what are you reading. There could be a sound effect for what are you reading. What are the challenges? Maybe there's some themes and some challenges that we can bring into the show. Let me know in the comments, or anyway, you reach out to me. We are on Instagram. If you don't know who we are, you can find out more about us over at Parenting Passports and Profits, myself, my partner, and my 2 daughters, and we would love to get to know you. And if you have something you want to share with us, come on the show and promote it. Come on the show and challenge yourself. I want to experiment with the different ways I can bring you on the show, and so that's me stepping out of my comfort zone and doing that, and you stepping out your comfort zone maybe and coming on the show. So I'm just going to close down Skype. I'm going to close down Skype so that I am not chewing through my phone. Okay. Website reviews, folks. If any of you want a website review, or you know someone who wants a website review who is willing to come on the show, or when I say on the show, just be, they don't have to come on the show, but they need to be live, I will do a website review. You know, I have a background in SEO now. We build websites. We've got some skills in getting people to opt into email lists and send email sequences. So we'll set up a timer and we'll do a little website review. I give you an overview of, you know, some things that might work, might not work, some things you can change. Keyword research we can do. So we can show you behind the scenes with a few things with this. We can do all this inside Ecamm Live and have some fun. So. And remember, you know, where in the world are you? So come at me, tell me where in the world you are. We would love to, let's get rid of that. What are you reading? We don't need that. Tell me in the comments where in the world you are. What's lockdown look like for you? And let's get to hear what's going on in the world. So yeah, it's been awesome having your company. If you've only just joined the show, you'll know that it is nearly 11:30 p.m. Central European time. The girls have gone to bed. If we can do an earlier show, the girls will come on, but right now there just doesn't seem enough hours in the day, especially when you spend half a day in a supermarket trying to get the family shopping. And so yeah, when I hang up here, I have got about an hour's worth of washing up. No dishwasher here in this. We've got a lovely house. We're house sitting in rural France. There's quite a lot of work to do to keep the property going, and feeding the kids and eating the chores don't go away. So I think I will find a YouTube video to watch and set it up behind the sink and watch some inspiration while I'm doing the washing up. So on that positive note, it's been absolute, let's just check in with the chat. Where's our chat gone? Awesome, thanks Brent. Awesome. And yeah, just keep an eye. Guys, if you're watching and you are new to the channel, maybe you can go with the subscribe and then you'll see the lives come up. Is there a way I can help you with that? How does that work? We got that over here. Oh, here we go. Yeah, guys, remember, you can subscribe to the channel, give us a like on the thing, and then you can set up notifications when these lives come on. I'm making a commitment. I'm going to try and do these daily. Certainly while we're locked down, we can't go anywhere. We've been in France. They've extended the confinement period till the 11th of May, so we were due to be here till the beginning of June anyway, but we definitely was hoping to see a bit of France and go out and practice some French, but you know, there's not a lot of scope to do a lot of talking with French people right now, which is a shame, because even our eldest was getting in on the act, and we got off to a good start, but now it's just the four of us talking to ourselves most of the time. So again, offering up companionship, connectivity, social connection. We can do all of those things by leveling up live with each other. So I invite you onto the show. You know, let me know what you share, what you're doing. Thanks for the like, appreciate that. Don't know who gave that, but whoever it was. Thanks for the boys who have been really great in the chat. That means a lot to me. And say, this is new. This is an experiment. And yeah, thanks, Dre. That's awesome. This is an experiment. I'd like to experiment with stuff for you guys. You know, we use a lot of online marketing tools. I've got some links in the description. ConvertKit, ConvertBox. Those are great for building email lists. We can do demos on those, and we can dive behind the scenes and do stuff for you. So yeah, invite your friends, tell people about it, subscribe to the channel. I'll keep going with these lives. I'm holding myself accountable to try and do them daily, even if it means I'm going to be up all night doing washing up. I'm going to try and fit them inside a 24-hour period for as long as it works for me and the family. And I'm of service to you guys. And there's people out there who need us, and they need stimulation, they need inspiration, they need help. And you know, maybe in 5 or 10 minutes we could do the webs, we could do the, you know, like I say, we have the countdown going, and in 8 minutes we might be able to point them in the right direction with a website review. So I'll just put that back. Let's turn that off. And where's my scenes? Here we go. Get rid of turn that off. Cool. So heaps we can do. Oh, more likes, thank you. And so over and out from Central France, wherever you are in the world, whether you're just waking up in New Zealand or Australia, or whether you are just coming to the end of your afternoon in maybe Central North America, or whether you're like me, up in the starry night, I'll bid you all the best to you and your family, to your business, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Over and out. Bye bye.